We know the drop shot rig is effective, but we might not always be tying and playing the drop shot to optimize our catch success. Adequate play height off the bottom and above cover is essential for a fish to see and feel our bait. Are those long casts killing your visibility? Are you really playing your bait as high off the bottom as you think to hit your target depth? Did you know that a rig tied the same way plays differently if you're standing on a boat platform versus being seated in a kayak? Does rod length matter? What about non-flat bottoms? Today we'll use some simulations to embrace a handful of key concepts that might just change how you fish this finesse rig, and even other fishing methods. I've also made for you a drop shot fishing simulator so you can simulate any adjustments you might want to make before you even hit the water. I am Cohen, this is Kay in Fishing Smarts, where we fishers are always learning and sharing knowledge about fishing and fishes, and after making that last drop shot video for y'all, I really felt I needed to clarify how much play height we're losing underwater and how our rig is actually presenting underwater. I believe anyone who's playing the drop shot could benefit from this video and hopefully pick up a thing or two. This is a multi-species rig, and as winter approaches and I've been healing my back, I've been doing a lot of mellow fishing, just playing the drop shot, going for crappie, and I've been working on a recipe, and of course I'll share that recipe with y'all if I can perfect it. I'm getting there. It's also cool seeing what other species are targeted by fishers on the drop shot, so it'd be cool if you shared your favorite target species down below so we can all just kind of see how versatile this rig really is. We're first going to introduce the drop shot, then we'll get into our key concepts, starting with how we hold the rod and the important angle, and why every fisher should understand what this important angle does to their rig's presentation. We'll explore what water depth does to your rig's presentation, then explain why long casts are just not your friend with the drop shot. Then we'll cover four ways to increase your play height on your rig to improve your rig's visibility and why that matters. We'll discuss how incline-decline bottoms affect your rig, and then we'll do a quick concept summary at the end. As always, I've put chapters on the video on the scroll bar down below, so you can just easily hop around the video or easily come back and reference a spot if you want to do that. And you don't have to know the math behind what we're doing here today. If you do, that's great, but we're focusing on basic concepts that we fishers can use, so I won't be showing the equations used to reach our concepts. Though, we are anglers, we make a lot of angles, and we make a lot of triangles when we are fishing. So really, as a fisher, you most likely just have an inner grasp of the trigonometric relationships that exist in this video. But for those of you curious about the actual calculations, I will post them at the KNFS website. And if you want to go check out the KNFS drop shot simulator now, it's free to use at koa.org/dropshotsim. I'll link that in this video's description as well. This simulator just lets you visualize how your rig would look underwater and how much play height you'll get the various ways you tie and play it. We'll use this simulator a few times in this video so you can see how it works, and you can test it out as we move along here if you want. It's nothing fancy. I'm not a programmer. I just spent a few days learning enough JavaScript, CSS, and HTML to code a couple programs that incorporate the trigonometric equations with some graphics and data output. Let's quickly go over what the basic drop shot is for anyone not familiar with this rig, or just a refresher if you haven't used it in a few years. The basic drop shot rig is an inline finesse rig that has a weight on the bottom and a hook sitting some distance above that weight. This rig is capable of targeting many different species of fishes at specific depths and various water types. Often we anglers are using a soft plastic as a bait that has an active wiggle, mimicking a live prey item, but pretty much anything can be put on that hook. The drop shot requires putting slack into the line to play the bait up and down while the weight remains on the bottom. We get slack by lowering the rod tip, and as we slack the line, the hook and bait fall, and when we bring the line completely taut, then we see we approach a max height our hook can achieve off the bottom. Unless we are reeling in or jerking the line with enough force to displace the rig, our weight will remain in the same location while the hook and bait move up and down. The most basic way to fish the drop shot is in a vertical fishing position, say from a boat where the drop shot has been dropped straight down. In this case, the hook is tied 1 foot from the dropper weight, so our hook's max play height is 1 foot off of the bottom, while that weight remains on the bottom. And FYI, just for simplicity, I consider the hook's height off the bottom where the hook is tied to the line, and the bottom is considered to be where the line is tied to the weight. Hook size, shape, and even how the bait is presented on that hook will slightly affect play height, but we won't dive into those complexities. It's just something to keep in mind. So that's the basic completely vertical drop shot. No height is lost to play the bait between the hook and bottom from how it was originally tied. But now let's look at the more typical situations when we're fishing and we're casting at angles. Here we have a KNFS fisher using the drop shot, fishing from a shoreline, and he's standing level with the water at the moment. We'll call this KNFS fisher Ben because he sort of looks like a patron of ours from Patreon. Actually, it kind of looks like both of our Bens from Patreon, so I thank you both for supporting KNFS. We'll notice that Ben is holding a 6'5" rod at a 22.5 degree max angle from the water level. And this is a good angle to start with because it's fairly simple to visualize. Just think of a 90 degree angle where a square is able to snug in there perfectly. Then chop that angle in half, which gives us a 45 degree angle. And then you chop it in half one more time and we get a 22.5 degree angle. And these are just good angles to remember in life for all sorts of things besides fishing. Ben is playing the drop shot rig by lowering his rod tip and raising it, but never exceeding that 22.5 degree angle. Remember, as he lowers his rod tip, he is putting slack in the line, which drops the hook and bait. And as he raises it to that max elevated position of 22.5 degrees to where the line is taut, we will see he has a max play height on his rig. And this 22.5 angle is around a good average max angle to hold the rod for the drop shot, give or take. We know that a 90 degree angle is impractical to fish. A 70 degree angle is still way too steep to make any hook set easy, and even a 45 degree angle is often a bit steep for properly making hook sets. There's a reason why when we first started learning how to fish, we were instructed to keep our rod tips low for most fishing methods, and it starts with leaving enough room for us to properly make that hook set. But with the drop shot, often we do have to keep our rod tip higher to properly play this rig. As Ben is fishing, he is creating a whole bunch of angles. But this angle right here is the most important angle to recognize. As Ben has his rod to the max elevated position where his line is taut, or perfectly straight, this angle will remain the same along the entire line and even on a flat bottom. And you'll notice that all we're doing is increasing the sides of the triangle while this angle remains the same along that line. This important angle is what we, as anglers, naturally focus on. And this important angle is what I want us to focus on throughout this video. It's what we as anglers can actually see when we are fishing as the line transitions into the water. And it's what we'll be using to approximate how high our hook is off the bottom. A narrow angle means our hook is much closer to the bottom than a wider angle. And this is the most essential concept to grasp from this video. And there is no math needed there. Just recognizing the size of that angle is what is absolutely essential to understanding your rig's presentation underwater. And I bet you incorporate this angle into your fishing, whether you realize it or not, you probably just have that innate understanding of its significance. So from here on out, I'm calling this the important angle. As we just saw, the important angle does not change with water depth, assuming all the other variables are staying the same. However, total cast distance will be farther away as the water depth is deeper. And this is a quick concept to grasp. The deeper the water, then the farther away your rig is, both along a vertical and horizontal plane. But water depth will not change your important angle on a taut line. So being able to see that important angle above water will tell you what that important angle is below water at any depth with a taut line. The drop shot rig is not optimized for long casts. Let's have Ben show us why this is by first starting with a very short cast where the line is penetrating the water only 2.5 feet in front of his rod tip, or about 8.5 feet from where he's standing. His important angle here is 67.5 degrees, and that is a big important angle. This translates to him losing only 7.6% of his play height on his rig, and that's a very small loss. So if he had tied his tag end so the hook is only 1 foot or 12 inches from the weight, then he'd only lose about an inch of play height. And that's adequate visibility on a flat gravel bottom and passable visibility if there are some short weeds or debris to clear. But now let's have Ben's line penetrate the water about 9 feet in front of his rod tip, or about 15 feet from where he is standing. Suddenly, his important angle is almost halved. He's losing more than 44% of his play height. So with that 1 foot tag end he originally tied, he's now barely sitting above a half foot or 6 inches of play height. And if it's that same bottom with those short weeds, his bait is now hidden instead of being able to play on top. And that's a bad situation for Ben's presentation. Not only is the bait hidden to a fish's visible sense or eyesight, but the pressure waves that his bait is creating are being absorbed by the plants. I'm sure you've heard of a fish's lateral line system. A fish has sensory cells on the head and body that detect vibrations within the water, and even a soft plastic bait moving in the water creates pressure waves that fish can feel. We want both the bait to be seen and to be felt by target fish. Let's have Ben cast farther out, but let's look at how we can use the KNFS Drop Shot Simulator to help us out. And this simulator might look a little intimidating, but it's all simple input. It will quickly do all the math for you, and there are only 6 input fields. You can either use the Imperial system, so that's for us fishers in the US using feet, and then there's the metric system, which is for pretty much everyone else in the world. Rod length is measured from end to tip. We have been using a 6.5 foot rod at the moment, so we just make sure that is in the appropriate box. Rod angle is the angle the fisher is holding the rod above a parallel plane to the water, so remember a 90 degree hold is totally impractical to fish, and even a 45 degree hold is a bit much. We have been using a 22.5 degree hold, which is the default here, so I don't need to change it. Height of rod butt above the water level is fairly self-explanatory, and this is an important variable that we will get to in a bit. But at water level, as a 6 foot tall guy, Ben's probably holding that rod butt 3.5 feet above the water level. Visible length of cast is the distance between the rod tip and where the line hits the water, and that's measured along a parallel plane to the water. And if you're wondering why I didn't go with total cast length here, I just felt visible cast length is more practical for us fishers to approximate as we can see it. You can still see total cast length after you hit calculate if you want to approximate your rig that way. And let's just give Ben a cast where the line penetrates the water 20 feet in front of his rod tip. The length of the tag end is the length between the hook and the weight as they are tied at the end of the rig. So we'll start with a short tied tag end of 1 foot. And finally, there is water depth, which is the depth of water where the weight of the rig sits on the bottom. So we'll make that an even 10 feet here. All we have to do is hit calculate, and we'll see how the rig appears underwater on the left. This will tell us how high the hook is tied off the bottom and how much height was lost from the original tag end's tie. Then on the right, we can see Ben's profile above water. We can see our important angle as well as how much fishing line is out and the total cast distance. So we had Ben to where his line is penetrating the water 20 feet in front of his rod tip, but you'll notice his total cast distance is actually about 53 feet away. So again, let's look back at our water depth concept. If we change the water depth to 1 foot here, now the total cast distance is only 23 feet away instead of 53 feet away. But that important angle and play height remains the same. And it is important to know what depth of water we are hitting, but we aren't going to know that precisely unless we have sonar and we're being able to see that specifically. We really just need to recognize that important angle above water. And here we can see on this fairly long cast, there is a narrow important angle of just over 16 degrees that's causing a 71% height loss, and that's a big loss of play height. And if we change the line penetrating the water to 30 feet, we see our important angle is lessened even more, and our play height is lessened as well. And this is a really dramatic loss, just over 80%. There's only about 2 inches of play height off the bottom here. Long casts cause the important angle to be very small, thus drastically reducing the play height. That may be fine if you're targeting fish hugging the bottom, like catfishes or a crappie just sitting in the mud, but for most other situations, you'll be lessening your odds of noticing the bait. Furthermore, long casts make finessing the drop shot almost impossible. Things like line sag and any light wind will complicate feeling the rig, not to mention the weight is harder to keep in a single spot on the bottom as it pulls in easier when it's farther away. And a heavier weight is really needed for those liking longer casts. So although long casts are just not practical with the drop shot, there are ways to increase your play height if you do like getting your rig out a good distance away. And the easiest and most effective way to increase your play height is just to tie your hook farther up the line from the weight. So let's say Ben is just hell-bent on starting with that long cast where the line is penetrating the water 20 feet in front of his rod tip. His port and angle is about 16.7 degrees, and that's small. He's losing 71% of play height. So if he tied a 1 foot tag end, his max play height off the bottom is only about 3.5 inches. But if he doubled his tag end length from 1 foot to 2 feet, he's essentially doubled his play height to just under 7 inches. And that's not great, but it might be exactly what Ben wants here. But you'll notice the percent loss of his play height doesn't change because the important angle doesn't change. He's still losing 71%. And if he tied a 3 foot tag end, then he'd have over 10 inches of play height. And with the simulator tool, you can easily see the data on this change. All you have to do is just change the tag end field to see how this information is at 1 foot. 2 feet, and 3 feet. Also of note, if we're casting the drop shot like we typically are, not trolling or drifting with it, I've just found a 4 foot tag end, anything bigger than a 4 foot tag end is just tedious to cast, but I will at times tie a 4 foot tag end if the situation warrants it. Some of you might think that's really long, and it is sort of if you're doing a bunch of casting, but it can pay out. And sometimes I'll do that not to get over cover on the bottom, but just because I think the bass are cruising around 3 to 6 feet. And it doesn't really matter the fish we're targeting. Odds of catching one improve if you stick a bait in front of their face or close to it. Sometimes a reaction hit is the hit we want, or it's the only thing we'll get. And I call this the chocolate donut theory. I love chocolate covered donuts, but if one is farther away, say all the way across the room, I might just not bother making the effort to go get it, but if it's sitting on a table right next to me, I'll probably grab that donut and stick it in my mouth. And really, that example just boils down to what any animal is going to do. Humans, ducks, your dog. It's all a balance of risk and reward in the world of biology. A fish needing to exert less energy to eat a prey item is taking less of a risk than if that prey item is farther away. The farther away that prey fish is, then the more likely the hunt will fail. Hence why most of our crankbaits and other baits are designed to mimic injured fish or other prey items. It's less of an energy risk for a predator fish to go after an injured fish that is easily caught versus a prey fish that is healthy and could zip away. And that's one reason the drop shot can be so great in the winter, especially in our northern latitudes here in North America, when many species literally change their anatomy in the winter to adapt for energy conservation. Most species will still eat in the winter, but these winter fish don't want to burn much energy. So dropping a lethargic presentation right in front of their nose may just convince them to take that easy meal. Another way to get more play height on the rig is simply to increase the rod angle, or the position we hold the rod tip over the water. Say Ben has the line penetrating the water about 10 feet in front of his rod tip with a 22.5 degree hold. His important angle is about 31 degrees, so he's losing over 48% of his play height. But if he was really wanting some more play height, he could increase that rod angle to 45 degrees, which now only results in a 37% loss of play height, if the line's still penetrating the water 10 feet in front of him. That's better than a 10% increase of play height, which could translate to almost 3 inches extra play height compared to that 22.5 degree hold. But by increasing the rod angle, this then increases the important angle, which then increases the amount of play height on the bottom. Though we do know we can't really increase our rod angle too much without hindering our ability to make an easy hook set. We know that fishing a longer rod helps with casting distance, but it will also help just a bit getting more play height on the drop shot. Now this is a comparison of a 6.5 foot casting rod versus an 8 foot casting rod hitting the exact same spot on the bottom about 26 feet away from where Ben is standing. And we'll notice that the longer rod creates a wider important angle, thus increasing the play height. It's only about a 4% increase, which isn't much, but sometimes every little bit helps. And this percentage increase will actually lessen the farther the cast is out. So we can't say increasing our rod length won't change our presentation, but it's really not significant enough to discourage anyone with a short rod from playing the drop shot. That's totally fine. We've been having Ben fish on a level plane with the shoreline. We're actually not going to be usually fishing with our feet perfectly level with the water. Often we're going to be fishing a bit higher off the water as we fish from a shore, a dock, and even a boat. Let's put Ben on a bass boat platform where he is 2 feet above the water level and he's holding his rod 3.5 feet above the platform. So his rod's end is now 5.5 feet above the water level instead of 3.5 feet. Let's give him a 6.5 foot rod where he has a cast with a line penetrating the water 15 feet in front of his rod tip. Just adding that 2 feet of height on the boat increased his important angle from 21.8 degrees to 28 degrees, meaning he went from having a 63% loss of height to a 53% loss of height. And that's a 10% increase. And if we put Ben in a kayak, where now he is much closer to the water, and where his rod butt is only 1.5 feet above the water, he has an important angle of 15 degrees, and that's a 74% loss of play height. So there is a big difference between being in a kayak and standing on a boat platform. However, this change is a little bit misleading. We need to keep in mind that as we've been changing the height hold above water, we are keeping the line penetrating the water at 15 feet, but the total cast length is different. The weight on the rig is farther away when Ben is lower to the water in the kayak. If we keep the total cast length the same as we change the height above water, or where basically Ben is hitting the same spot on the bottom from the same lengthwise distance away, we won't see as dramatic of a difference. But we can clearly see that more play height is rewarded while being higher up, and that is the main concept to grasp here. Being higher up will create a wider important angle, thus increasing the allowable play height. So sitting in a kayak versus standing on a boat platform will change the play height off the bottom. While Ben's in the kayak, he could use a longer rod to help make up the difference. An 8-foot rod would give him back over 4% play height to hit the same distance away. Though if you're a kayak fisher, you know that fishing a long rod in a kayak is sometimes just not practical, especially if you need to net a fish. And all of this really depends on what max play height Ben wants to achieve off the bottom. He could want 2 inches, 2 feet, or 10 feet. And we know there is no single one correct way to play the drop shot rig. It's a finesse rig that incorporates our individual strategies and creativities. And it's dependent on many other variables too, like the time of year, what species we're targeting, etc., etc. Typically, when I'm going for bass on the drop shot, I'm using a 7.5 foot casting rod and typically tying my leader about 24 inches from my weight, unless I know the bottom is just covered in weeds or I'm fishing a non-flat bottom. Then I'm willing to make my tag in 3 or even 4 feet. But I'm not often throwing long bomb casts on the drop shot. I like my max play height off the bottom or above weeds to be at least 6 inches, and usually more than that. Let's think about one more very important concept before we get to our main concept summary here. The bottom isn't always going to be flat, and a lot of times you'll be fishing on an angled bottom. And if you are fishing from a shoreline, typically that means you'll be losing max height off of your play height. And if you're fishing on a boat casting toward shore, you'll actually be gaining a little bit of play height. And I did go ahead and make an add-on program for you to simulate this, and you'll just need your important angle, your tag end length, and approximate that bottom angle. And you can really see how much play height you'll be gaining or losing just by changing that bottom angle. And really, the best way to visualize losing height when casting from shore is just to think about your important angle getting chopped by whatever angle that bottom is. So here Ben thought he was fine with a 1 foot tag end with his 35 degree important angle because he was getting what he wanted, more than 6 inches or a 0.5 foot of play height on the level bottom. But with a 10 degree incline shoreline, it's chopping out about 1.7 inches of his max play height. So if he wants at least a 6 inch minimum play height, he needs to increase his tag end length or adjust how he's playing that rig. I was born in Colorado. I spent most of my life there. Hence why I root for the Colorado Avalanche. Fishing for trout in most of those mountain lakes meant really steep shoreline transitions. The drop shot fish from these steep drop-offs is really hard to get much play height. However, from a boat hitting the other side of that incline, you'll actually be getting plenty of play height. All right, so we've gone over quite a bit. Let's just review all our main concepts here. The important angle is the angle between the water and the line where the line penetrates the water. And this angle remains the same anywhere along the line on a perfectly taut line, and it'll be the same on a flat bottom. A larger or wider angle means a taller max height the hook is off the bottom compared to a shorter, narrower angle. Because you can see this angle penetrating the water, this angle should be your main source for approximating how high off the bottom your hook is on the drop shot. A 90 degree important angle means you're fishing right above the bait and not losing play height. A 45 degree important angle on a flat bottom means you only lose about 29% of play height, and a narrow 15 degree important angle will result in about 74% loss of play height. Water depth does not change your important angle, but the deeper the water depth, the farther out your cast is from where you can see the line hit the water. Longer casts will narrow your important angle and cause you to lose play height on the drop shot. This is not a rig optimized for long casts. The easiest way to get more play height on your rig is just to tie your hook farther from the weight. Sometimes a few extra inches of visibility will mean the difference between catching nothing and catching something really big. Widening the angle you hold your rod tip above water will increase your important angle. This then increases your max height the hook is off the bottom, or play height. However, increasing the angle you hold your rod too much will lessen your ability to ensure a proper hook set. A longer rod will also increase your important angle, thus increasing the play height of your rig off the bottom. It's not a tremendous amount, but sometimes every little bit counts. The position you hold the end of your rod above the water will affect your important angle. Fishing higher up off the water, say from a dock or a boat platform, will allow for more max play height than if you were fishing while seated in a kayak. Fishing non-flat bottoms will affect your rig's play height. Generally, this means that fishing from shore, you'll lose some height, and fishing from a boat towards shore, you'll actually gain some height. So again, the KNFS Drop Shot Fishing Simulator, it's free to use. It's nothing fancy. Its practical purpose is just for you to mess around with the situation you might get into. For example, I like fishing from my belly boat, and I'm only able to hold my rod about 6 inches off the water. So let's say I want my minimum play height to be 1 foot. I can use the simulator to just sort of see how long I should tie my tag end and then how short I should keep my casts. So just messing around with the numbers, I probably want my tag end at 3 feet and I want to keep my casts fairly short. And then I can go use the incline decline adjuster to see if there are any other adjustments I should make. Considering I'll probably be casting at shore in the belly boat for most casts, I'll just expect a little bit more play height. And so although we showed rod length isn't too important, I know a lot of fishers that prefer to sit in a boat while fishing with mostly short casts, so we know a short rod is probably just better choice for that play style. And for fishers that prefer to longer to medium casts, a longer rod is better. Just taking those extra percentage points on the play height isn't a bad thing at all.
And considering this is a finesse rig, we really want a fast action rod. That's typically best, assuming said fast action rod is of high sensitivity. That's really what's most important, the high sensitivity bar. We want to feel our bait and our weight as they move along the bottom and up and down. And that fast action type on a rod is really an ambiguous term, and it's dependent on the manufacturer's own definition of their rods. But typically your fast action rods are high sensitivity. And that sensitivity is also going to be dependent on what reel you have attached to that rod. I was doing some maintenance here. So this Shimano Trenx is it's a metal, solid metal composite one-piece housing. And that's going to have great vibrational transference compared to, say, a multi-piece plastic housing. So also don't forget to post what species you love targeting on the drop shot. All right. I hope I altered some perspectives here. Fish responsibly and good luck.